Hey, Shalom. This is Officer Lavi, IUIC Dallas, cuts from the street. And who I got with me to my right?
Marcus Cooks.
So, Brother Marcus Cooks. So, we're going to get right into it. So, this year, in a couple more days or whatever, Thanksgiving is going to come around. Are you excited to celebrate Thanksgiving this year?
Yes, I am. I get to see my family, and I get to go travel to Tyler to see him and see my mom and my brothers too. I get to play some games with them on the Xbox and have fun. I also get to probably go to church. I get to go to church on Sunday and sing, and what else I get to do? Thanksgiving. Oh, eat some pie, eat some delicious pumpkin pie on Thanksgiving. It's so fun. And play some football or something with family. I don't know about that. COVID's in the way, but we're probably still gonna do it. We're still gonna have a little fun. Oh, and then my town, Thanksgiving right now. We don't know turkey though. The turkey place blew up. Did y'all know about that?
You said the turkey place blew up in your town. Where, uh-huh. Where your town at?
Tyler, Texas.
Mm-hmm. And the turkey place blew up. Ain't that something?
So what I want to do now is show you what happens when you do the wrong thing.
Hey, Shalom, Israel. This is Officer Amasa, and I have with me
Isaiah Reed.
Isaiah? Mm-hmm. Reed. I thought you said your name was David.
Oh, no. That was a mistake.
Okay, what is your name?
Isaiah Reed.
I've got a strong name here. Brother said his name was David, now it's Isaiah. But Isaiah's a strong name too. Yes, and Isaiah, let me ask you, now, are you gonna celebrate Thanksgiving this year?
Sir. Yes, sir.
And so what does Thanksgiving look like in your house?
Food, you got a game going on, and everybody just started eating and stuff like that, having fun.
You go family to family? I mean, do you go to your grandma's house, you go to your uncle's house, start out at mom's house?
Yeah, we stay at our house.
Who does the cooking?
My mama.
What does she normally cook?
Not turkey, but ham, dressing, greens, stuff like that.
So what does it look like in Brother Marcus's house on Thanksgiving? Like, as far as what can somebody expect when they come to Marcus' house for Thanksgiving?
Oh, we will have food sometimes. I'll be cooking some cheesecake, or we'll be having TV on probably. And we probably go to family and talk and go to grandma's probably. And we will see fam. And what else will we do on Thanksgiving? It'd be warm in there. It wouldn't be like chilly outside.
okay. Well, okay. So
we have fish in there too.
So it sounds like y'all be getting it in on Thanksgiving.
Nah, we be having fun and talking to family, playing dominoes.
Okay. Dominoes. I like the bones.
And so, the idea of celebrating Thanksgiving, what does that holiday, that holy day, what does that mean to you and your family?
Be thankful for everything that you got. That year, you know what I'm saying? Thank God for letting you see another Thanksgiving, you know?
And so you're thanking God for the blessings that your family received, and that's what you're being thankful for?
Yes, sir.
Do you know the history or any of the background on what Thanksgiving truly is?
They was talking about that today at my school, but I'll be honest with you, man, I really wasn't into it like that.
I can understand. I can dig it. You still in high school or you in college?
I'm in high school.
What's your what grade level?
I'm in ninth grade.
Ninth grade? That makes you about how old?
I'm 15.
15 years old. In your school books at school, do they teach you about Thanksgiving?
Nope.
So now Thanksgiving had something to do with the pilgrims and them coming to America, and the people who were already living here.
What
do you know about that?
That's what they was talking about today, about pilgrims and Native Americans and all that kind of stuff. How they sat down and had turkey and that kind of stuff.
Did they tell you who the pilgrims were?
Nope.
Were the pilgrims the Europeans or were they from some other place?
I don't know.
What did they look like?
They showed us pictures of Native Americans.
And so the Native Americans, did they show you that they opened up their arms to the pilgrims, taught them how to grow crops, taught them how to fish, taught them how to live, things like that?
Mm-hmm. Sir.
Did they also tell you that in exchange, the pilgrims gave the Native Americans smallpox blankets or blankets with smallpox in it?
They didn't tell me that. That's why I say I wasn't really into it. I was doing some other makeup work for some other classes, so I wasn't like really into it. So
I understand. You go to Fort Worth Independent School District?
Yes, sir.
And so they don't teach you that the so-called pilgrims, they massacred over 70 million so-called Native Americans as they came here. Did they teach you anything like that in your school?
Nope.
Do you know the history of Thanksgiving, the origin of Thanksgiving?
A little bit. The pilgrims in like 17 something something had found a turkey and they started gathering up and they killed it with a bow and they were just in a little Massachusetts colony just celebrating all together and dancing.
You say all together with who?
The Indians. They were all together with the Indians. I think they're Indians.
So what?
And the Americans.
So what you learned was, or what you know of, is that the pilgrims, which are the Europeans, am I right?
Yes.
And the Indians would be the Native American Indians, right?
Yes, yes.
So you say they got together and they killed a turkey and they had a feast.
Uh-huh, they had a feast together.
So from what you know, uh-huh, of about Thanksgiving. So what if I told you the original origins of Thanksgiving was the murder of the Native American Indians, over 77 million of them?
Wow. I never knew that. That's like, they murdered them. That never. I would say, wow. What's the word for it? Astonished. I didn't know that. That's something to know about. That's wow.
So, that's where Thanksgiving originated from. It originated from the pilgrims, the Europeans. They came over to this side of the earth, and they destroyed the Native American Indians, took their land, killed them, killed their babies, their women.
Wow.
And put them on reservations. And now they say,
wow,
Thanksgiving, let's eat a turkey. So, with you knowing that, would you continue to celebrate Thanksgiving?
Wow.
Let me put it this way. Say for instance, right?
Mm-hmm.
Me and you were friends, right? And you were Native American. And I was a white person.
Mm-hmm.
And Thanksgiving came around. And I said, hey, let's go celebrate Thanksgiving, the slaughter of your ancestors. How would that make you feel?
Wow, I was a Native American?
I'm just in just for an example. Yeah, you the Native American.
Oh, wow.
And I'm the white person. And I'm saying, let's go celebrate,
man,
the slaughter of your people called Thanksgiving. How would that make you feel?
It made me angry, actually. It would make me angry because they slaughtered our families, and now we're gonna celebrate my probably dad dying or something. That would be mad.
I'm Officer Amasa, Israel United in Christ, out of Dallas. Hey, with me tonight is who?
Tim Salazar.
And Tim, you've got a team with you. Who is this cutie?
This is my daughter, Callie Sky. I got my son Bryce and the mother son Dash.
They're all excited about Dad doing an interview, right?
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Hey, check this out. So the conversation that we're having with people is about this this time of the year. Everyone is excited about Thanksgiving. And so what does Thanksgiving look like at your house?
Thanksgiving for me, man, is just hanging out with the family, man, to be honest with you. Just hanging out with family. I'm a Cowboys fan, born in Lubbock, Texas, but, you know, been here since 2011, Dallas, Fort Worth, so watching the Cowboys play, always been, you know, just watching my dad be a Cowboys fan growing up. So hanging out, being with family, eating, just hanging out, like, that's what Thanksgiving to me is, just being grateful for everything you got.
So basically it's a big celebration, a family celebration, and it's a lot of cooking, a lot of eating. Do you know the meaning of what you're celebrating?
To be honest with you, I don't. It's just, for me, I've always grown up at Thanksgiving, it's just being around your family and just watching football. So to me, the meaning, what Thanksgiving means to me is just to be with my family, hang out. Like I said, since I moved to Dallas-Fort Worth, I don't have as much family here as I did back home in Lubbock. So just hanging out and being close with my family and just watching the games. It doesn't matter. You don't even have to talk, to be honest with you. It's just hanging out, just being around in the presence. Like, it's just that energy, that feeling you get just hanging around your family.
Let me ask you, so the Thanksgiving is not in the Bible. Do you read the Bible?
A little bit. I used to read it quite a bit, but I honestly don't read it as much.
Let me ask it this way. Do you believe in the Word of God?
Oh, without a doubt.
Yeah. And so you do pray.
Oh, for sure.
And so at Thanksgiving at your house, does someone like maybe you're designated, hey, lead the prayers, Tim?
To be honest with you, there's not. We all just do it on our own.
Okay.
So but it's like you said, it's without a doubt, like before you even do it, it's you pray on your own, say what you need to do, you talk to your God, and before you, it's been like that.
All right. So let me give you a little history on Thanksgiving. A lot of times you won't get a lot of this knowledge until you get to college. Have you been to college?
I did. I went to school at West Texas A&M and Texas Tech.
You already have your degree?
Yes, sir.
All right. What did you get a degree in?
Business administration.
You had to take one of the core classes was history.
Yeah.
Okay. American history, right?
Yeah.
All right. And then Texas history, of course. All right. So in taking those courses, do you recall there being the pilgrims coming over? The first pilgrims coming over and them having contact with the so-called Native American.
Yeah, you hear about them coming to Jamestown, them coming to, you know, settle Platinum Rock, all that other thing.
Plymouth Rock.
So
do you remember, so one of the things that the Native Indians did is that they taught them how to survive. They taught them how to grow crops and how to fish and how to live that first winter.
Yeah. I remember that.
All right, and so, but later we find out that the pilgrims, they massacred over 77 million of the Native Indian, right?
Yeah, oh, for sure. Yeah. But that's something, you mean, isn't really taught, but.
They're not the teachers.
No, it's not really taught in the public school, so that's something that, you know, a lot of people miss.
Yeah.
And if you're not, I mean, if you don't read or do any kind of history, you're going to, honestly, whatever the school tells you, you're going to think that's really what happened. And, you know, that's, to be honest with you, that's not exactly what happened at all times. So they can tell you, hey, they came here, this is what happened. But at the end of the day, you know, somebody's writing that history. And obviously, if I'm writing it, I can say whatever I want to say. I can say whatever has happened. I said this, right, and this, and I can leave out some truth. So it's not.
That's right. Because they did write down that the so-called pilgrims, they put smallpox inside of blankets and gave those blankets to the Native Indians.
Exactly, yeah. Obviously, yeah. It's a massacre, try to get rid of people. It's,
yeah, and they destroyed them. But
so, do you believe in the Bible at all, Brother Marcus?
Yes, I believe in the Bible, yes. That God created the earth and created the heavens and the daylight and the... Yes.
Okay. So we're gonna read get a few scriptures for you on the topic of what happened to the Native American Indians that the so called white people did today. Right? Watch this. Give me Psalms 55 and verse 20. So Psalms 55 and verse 20. Read.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 55 and verse 21.
20.
He put forth his hand against such as be at peace with him.
So when the white men came over here, the pilgrims, he put forth his hand, like, you know, to shake somebody's hand.
Mm-hmm.
It means, you know, peace. This is how the Europeans came to the side of the earth when the Native Americans was here. They came here saying, we want to make peace with you.
Mm-hmm.
And they signed different treaties and so forth like this with the Native Americans, meaning what? We're going to have peace among you. We don't want to come here and have no strife. We just want to be peaceful when we come. Read.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
Meaning, when it says the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, was saying, look, we're going to have these treaties. And this is what we're gonna abide by. You understand? We come with nothing but peace. We're not coming with a war or nothing. We're coming with peace. Read.
But war was in his heart.
but war was in his heart, meaning his mind. Although he was speaking peace, but he was thinking about war in his mind the whole time. Read.
His words were softer than all.
Read.
Yet were they draweth swords.
So it says his words were softer than all. He was smooth talking to Native Americans, but yet they were drawing swords to do what? To kill the Native Americans. Mm-hmm. And this is where Thanksgiving came about. The slaughter of who? The Native Americans, mm-hmm. which is your brothers according to the Bible.
Wow.
We are the same people. Did you know that? The Native Americans and so-called black people today and Hispanics, we are the same people. We're the Israelites. That's who we be.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
It says, surely oppression maketh the wise man mad. Remember the example that I gave you. If you were the Native American and I was a white person,
mm-hmm.
and I said, let's go celebrate Thanksgiving, the slaughter of your ancestors, you said that would make you mad.
Uh-huh.
It says, what? Read it again.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
Uh-huh. Thanksgiving is a form of oppression. You said that would make you mad,
uh-huh,
if you
okay.
was a Native American. Read.
And a gift destroyeth the heart.
Their gift today is Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
Our people celebrate Thanksgiving and it destroys us. It destroys our mind to thinking this is a good thing, to thinking that we're having some type of gain or a good holiday to celebrate, which was evil. This is an evil holiday because okay. this is the slaughter of the Native Americans. Over 77 million Native Americans was killed for you to eat turkey dressing,
wow.
you know, the cheesecake and so forth. So knowing that, would you continue to celebrate Thanksgiving knowing that this was the slaughter of the Native Americans?
Which is us.
Which is us.
No, I wouldn't.
All praise to the Most High. So this is what we are here to do. We are here to show our people what they really are celebrating because we don't really know what we're celebrating. We just been taught these things in school that it was the pilgrims and they came over here with peace and then they had a turkey dinner. It was more to it. They killed them. That's how they got this land. They robbed and stole this land by rape, rob, and murder. So with that, we say shalom.
But so going back to Thanksgiving, and so you said you believe in the Bible.
Yeah.
Tim, I want to read a script or two for you, okay? All right. And so we keep walking further and further away, and my cord is getting... so there we go. All right. Hey, let me... what do you have? Job? Do you have Job 14 and 4?
Yes, sir.
Actually, give me Proverbs 3 and 31 first. Okay, she's getting a little heavy, huh?
No, she's getting cold. So
oh,
nice.
Okay. All right. We're going to read the book of Proverbs. You got that?
Yes, sir. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor and choose none of his ways.
So in this instance, the Bible is saying that we're not to follow the oppressor. And so under Thanksgiving, was there an oppressor and a victim in the history of it?
I mean, obviously the victim was the Native Americans in the whole situation. I mean, you're trying to help somebody and all of a sudden you get somebody give you smallpox and a blanket. And
right.
Yeah.
And so it says choose none of his ways. And so what are some of the ways that like Thanksgiving is one of the ways, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so if the Bible, if God is telling us, envy thou not the oppressor and choose none of his ways, that would include Thanksgiving, you think?
I think so.
Yeah. Especially knowing the history of what what they did, the conquistadors, what they did to the so-called Native Indian, what they did to Issachar or the so-called Mexican.
Yeah.
All right. Have you read what Christopher Columbus and his people did to the so-called Mexican?
No, you can tell me. What's
yeah, 1462, 1492, Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue. And so his people came in and they just massacred in the conversion of the so-called in the converting of Issachar into being a Mexican. They burned them, they chopped their hands and feet off, and they did it to make them follow their doctrines,
yeah.
this thing called Christianity, and follow their ways. They tried to enslave them, and they just killed millions of them.
Yeah.
Same thing they did with the Native Indian. And so today, when we're celebrating the holy day or the holiday called Thanksgiving, we're actually celebrating the slaughter of millions of people.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, and so knowing that, do you still want to celebrate Thanksgiving?
It makes you rethink things, but I hate to say it, it's been such a tradition with so many people. So things like it makes you really think, okay, well, what am I really celebrating? Things like that. What am I really celebrating? Am I think now some people, unfortunately, don't really think like that. So it makes them think, oh, well, I'm celebrating Thanksgiving because it's just me and my family watching this. Or, we you know, granddad cooks a turkey, something like that. And it's not the same. If you really, I guess, I mean, if you really deep down, dig deep into it, you really figure out what you're celebrating.
So if we know better, we do better.
Exactly. Yeah. You know better, you do better.
So now that you know a little bit about it, are you going to go back and do some research to determine whether or not you and your family may want to celebrate Thanksgiving?
No, for sure. Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
Yeah, I mean, because if it was really the celebration of the massacring of a group, a large group of our relatives, your relatives and mine, we don't want to celebrate that.
Oh, yeah, you look at it, Thanksgiving, Columbus Day, all that kind of stuff. It goes back to it. It was just a huge massacre. It makes you realize and makes you think twice about celebrating stuff like that.
Okay, your daughter's cold. So with that, we'll say shalom. And so the day Thanksgiving, did they teach you that you're celebrating the massacre of the so-called Native Americans, the Native Indian, and we're celebrating the fact that the Pilgrims or the so-called Europeans won?
That's not what we celebrating. See, we not celebrating none of that. See, we be thankful. That's what Thanksgiving means to us. Like, you know what I'm saying? Be thankful for what you got. All that you got, because other people out there that don't got as much as you got or don't got nothing that you got.
Right. So to you, it's just a celebration with family. Thanksgiving means just getting with family and celebrating that we have some things that other people don't have.
It means like be thankful for what you have, and everybody get together, you know what I'm saying, bring something, and you know what I'm saying, everybody tell each other that they love them and stuff like that.
Okay.
You know.
Isaac, let me ask you, do you read the Bible? Do y'all go to church?
Yeah, we go to church. I haven't been because of the COVID-19 situation.
I understand. I'm going to read something to you out of the Bible real quick. Give me Proverbs 3:31. Now, I don't know if you've read this or not. Have you read the Bible?
Not yet, but I do know some books.
Okay. So I'm going to read this, and then I'm going to ask you if it means anything to you with relations to Thanksgiving. All right? All right. You ready?
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways.
Now, Isaac, did you hear that?
Can you read that?
We'll read it again.
Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways.
Did you hear that? Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways. So, Isaac, the first question I would have for you with relations to that script, who are the oppressors?
Pilgrims.
Pilgrims, right. Yeah. And the Bible, which is the word of God, it says, choose none of their ways. What does that mean in relation to Thanksgiving?
That means don't go the way that the pilgrims are going, right?
Right, exactly. So should we be doing Thanksgiving, or should we be following God saying, don't do what the heathen do, don't do what the oppressor does?
Well, see, I'm going to tell you like this. So you saying that Pilgrims did this and that, and that's why we're celebrating Thanksgiving, right?
Well, that's not what I'm saying. I think historically, that's factually true, that the pilgrims came here, and the so-called Native Indian, who were already here, they taught them how to survive. And in teaching them how to survive, in exchange, the homes that the so-called Native Indian had, those were taken from them. The slaughter, that's historically true. Yeah. And so we're celebrating the European victory over the Native Indian.
Okay, so that's okay. So I know now. I see what you're saying.
So should we?
That's not what we celebrating. We celebrating. All we know is that all we know is, you know what I'm saying, be thankful for what you got. That's all my mama taught us. No, she said she said we know we already know that some bad things behind that, but you said we ain't gonna listen. Like we ain't gonna worry about that, because that's not why we're celebrating. We're not celebrating because we're not even celebrating because Native Americans. So we celebrating because we want to celebrate to so everybody can get around and everybody be thankful for what they got. It's the same thing they do at school. As soon as after Thanksgiving break, as soon as we get back from school, all the teachers asking us, what did y'all do for Thanksgiving? Then what is y'all thankful for and stuff like that?
Okay.
So we honestly, be honest, I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't really worry about the pilgrims and all them people.
I can dig it. I can dig it.
If they did do that stuff, that's the same on them.
Right. Let me show you something real quick. First off, you told me earlier that you do believe in the Bible. Mm-hmm. That means if God were to give you some instruction, you would do what God told you to do.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I mean, and me too, because I'm afraid of God. Are you afraid of God?
Yes, sir.
And so this is his word. Would you agree? Mm-hmm. Let's see what his word says, all right?
This is the book of Job, chapter 14 and verse 4. Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Not one.
Did you understand that? Mm-hmm. Did you hear it?
Yes,
you understood it?
Yes, sir.
What does that mean?
It means that you can't bring, if something is bad and it's really bad, you can't cover it up and make it good at all because it's already bad.
That's right. And so the first thing that I had, the script that I read to you was that, envy thou not the oppressor and choose none of his ways. That was the word of God. Mm-hmm. All right. And so when you leave and you go and talk with your parents, your mom, about Thanksgiving, will you have a discussion with her about what the Bible is saying?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask her, too, because y'all came and talked to me. You ain't come and talk to me for no reason. Huh?
That's right.
Uh-huh. So I'm going to tell her about it.
What are you going to say to her?
I'm going to ask her about it. I'm going to be like, I'm going to go to the script. Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask her about it. I'm going to read it to her. I'm going to ask her about it. And let me see what she said, what's her opinion on it.
Right. Are we celebrating, is Thanksgiving the celebration of the slaughter of the so-called Native Indian?
Yes.
Is that going to be your question?
Yes, sir.
And,
all right. And so I'm going to ask her that. But, because see me, honestly, myself, you know what I'm saying, not my mom, not, that's just me not missing my mom. I never, if I would have known about it, I still would have been like, okay, well, see, that's a shame on all the pilgrims, and I'm not going to go with what they did. I'm not going to believe in them at all. Every time somebody bring them up, I'm not going to say nothing about them, good about them at all, because, I don't like what you did, so that don't make you a good person, so I shouldn't be talking about you or saying anything good about you because you're not a good person. It's what you said. No clean could come out the unclean, right?
I didn't say that. That was the Bible.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
That's the word of God.
Well,
right?
That's what you read. Right. So, you know what I'm saying? That's how I'm going to treat it. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to be like, man, you ain't clean at all. So I can't mess with that. I can't be in control of that. But see, me, Thanksgiving, I always tell everybody, you know what I'm saying, just thank you for all the stuff that you gave me. Even though I do give, I just still be like, thank you for all the stuff you gave me. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for having me get some stuff like that.
But Isaac, now that you know better, we're going to do better, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I hear you saying.
Yeah.
All right.
So, yeah, so now that I know better, I ain't going, you know what I'm saying, I'm going to know, now that I know the true meaning, you know what I'm saying, it ain't going to be no discussion about it. None of that.
All right, you got a card from us?
A card?
We're going to give you a card, a contact, where you can go online, you can get YouTube videos all day. You can get taught on the Bible, okay?
All right.
Israel, with that, we say shalom.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.